Friends, we are now in part 4 video. In last previous video, part 3, we have seen the definition of limit and we have seen the exercise 5.2 first subdivision fully. And I gave you 5 assignment problem. In that, the 5th question is creative problem I gave you. Isn't it? How many of you have completed that? Students, you everyone has to try the creative question. Only then you can score good marks. From now onwards, you have to make the habit of solving the creative questions. Clear? Now, in part 4 session, we are going to continue the same exercise 5.2. From second question onwards, we are going to solve. Now, see the second question. If limit x tends to a, x power 9 minus a power 9 divided by x minus a is equal to limit x tends to 3 bracket x plus 6, then find the value of a. Here they were asking me what is the value of a we have to find. Solution. These two they have given in the question. So I have written given, I have written what they were given in the question, the same thing I have written here. Now see in the x minus a, if you are having for that you are having the same power, means immediately what formula you have to think, what formula your mind has to think. This formula, limit x tends to a, x power n minus a power n divided by x minus a is equal to n into a power n minus 1. This formula immediately you have to think. Clear? See? So now limit x tends to a, x minus a in the place of n, what we are having? 9 we are having. So how can we write now? Equal to n into a power n minus 1. So n, instead of n we are adding 9. So we can write 9 into, dot means into, 9 into a power 9 minus 1. How we are writing this? According to this formula. Here equal to, here limit x tends to 3 they are saying. So x tends to 3 means what? Wherever you are having x, we have to substitute 3. Here x tends to 3 they are given. So here we are having x. So in this place we are going to substitute now 3. Okay. Once if you are substituting 3, then you have to leave this limit. Okay. 3 plus 6. So in this side 9 dot a power 9 minus 1 is what? 8. Okay. You should not say dot. 9 into a power 8 we have got is equal to 3 plus 6 is 9. A power 8 is equal to 9 divided by 9. So 9 divided by 9 answer is what? 1. So A power 8 is equal to 1. Then in question we have to find only the value of A, isn't it? So what we are going to do is we are going to substitute A as 1 and minus 1. Okay, only then you will get the same answer as 1. You see that side, substituting A equal to 1. Implies, so 1 power whole power 8 is equal to 1. So how we are writing this? Will you able to understand? In the here what we are having, a power 8 is equal to 1 we are having, isn't it there? So a means what? We have taken 1. 1 power 8 is equal to 1. 1 into 1 into 1 into 1 into 1 into 1. 1 if you multiply 8 times, what we will get? Same 1 only will get. Implies 1 power 8 is 1 is equal to this one. Clear? The next one is we are applying minus 1. Okay. So now if you see a equal to minus 1. So again in the place of a we are writing minus 1 whole power 8. Clear? So if in minus if you are having the power, if you are having even number, means it will become into positive. That you all know, isn't it? From lower class onwards we have learned that, isn't it? So if in power, if you are having even number, means the minus will become positive. Suppose in power, if you are having odd number, means the minus will become same minus itself. Clear? So here what we are getting, power is even. So minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into, if you multiply for 8 times, we will get same 1 only, equal to 1. Only in the two cases we will get is equal to 1. Isn't it? So, therefore the value of A are plus or minus 1. Clear? With this, our second problem is over. Next, your third problem is here, homework. Now, we will do the fourth question. Friends, we are now in part 4, fourth question. If f of x is equal to x power 7 minus 128 divided by x power 5 minus 32, then find limit extends to 2 f of x. See, we have to find limit extends to 2 f of x value we have to find. Clear? Solution we will see now. Limit extends to f of x. This f of x value, what is given in the question? Limit extends to 2, I have written. In the place of f of x, what we are having? X power 7 minus 128 divided by x power 5 minus 32. Now, if you see here, in the here we are having the power as 7 and the down we are having power as 5. So, in order to make this number also power 7, we are taking the LCM. See, there I have done the LCM for 128. So, if I take LCM, what are the values I am getting? I am getting continuously 2. So, how many times I am getting 2? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times I am getting 2. So, x power 7 minus this 128, how can we write now? 2 power 7. Clear? Divided by x power 5. This 32, if you take LCM, how many 2 we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5 times 2 we are getting. So, you write, instead of 32, you write 2 power 5. Clear? Now, I have told you the third question itself. If you are having the same power, means immediately you have to think what formula? Limit extends to a, x power n minus a power n divided by x minus a equal to n into a power n minus 1. Immediately you have to think in your mind that formula. But if you see here, only x power 7 minus 2 power 7, the numerator part only here we are having. We don't have the denominator part. Denominator part what? X minus 2 we need? No, we are not having. Similarly for this also, only power numerator part we are having. We don't have the denominator part. What we have to get? X minus 2 we are not having. So, what we are going to do is multiplying and dividing by x minus 2. Here we are going to multiply and divide by x minus 2. See how we are doing that. Limit extends to 2. X power 7 minus 2 power 7 dividing with x minus 2. Here next the same x minus 2 I am multiplying here. Into x minus 2, here the denominator is what? X power 5 minus 2 power 5. Now if you see here, limit extends to 2, x power 7 minus 2 power 7. It looks like same form, no? X power n minus a power n divided by x minus a. Here x minus 2, here also x minus 2 we have got. So to make it to write in the formula form, we are converting like this. See here, we need the power should be in the numerator. This x minus 2 has to go to the denominator. Only according to that, only we are having formula. Isn't it? So, to make it in that form, we are writing 1 divided by limit extends to 2. This limit we are getting, taking inside. Limit extends to 2. This power we are writing up and this x minus 2 will go to the denominator. Clear? This part we are writing as such there. Only this, the power we are taking up and this we are taking down. For that, how we have to write this? 1 divided by. Clear, student? The same fourth problem in part 3 video, first question, fifth subdivision we have done. The same model we have done there also. If you go through it, means you can able to understand it clearly. See, limit extends to 2, x power 5 minus y power 5 divided by x minus 2. Now, both we have taken into this form. Now, how can we write now? Is equal to n into a power n minus 1. Okay, so now in the place of n, what we are having? 7. In the place of a, what we are having here? 2. So equal to n into a power n minus 1. So n is 7. 7 into a is 2. N again, n is 7 minus 1 into 1 divided by. Now if you see here n is 5, a is 2. So n is 5. 5 into a is 2. 2 power 5, n is what? 5 minus 1. Clear? Next step, if you see 7 into 2, 7 minus 1 is 2 power 6 divided by 5 into 5 minus 1 is what? 4. So 2 power 4. Now 2 power 6, 2 power 4, if you cancel, what we will get? Remaining 2, 2 will get, isn't it? See, for example, I have written 2, I have written 6 times. Similarly, denominator by 2, I have written 4 times. So first 2, 1, this 2, this 2, this 2 and this 2 have cancelled. Remaining how many 2 we are having? 2, 2. So that I have written 7 by 5, 2, 2 means 2 square we can write. Isn't it? Next step, 7 into 2 square answer is what? 2 into 2 is what? 4. So 7 4s are what? 28 by 5. Here, now the limit extends to 2, f of x answer is what? 28 by 5 is our answer. Clear all of you? Clear? Next, we'll see the 5th question. Next, in part 4 video, now we are going to see the 5th question. See, let f of x is equal to ax plus b divided by x plus 1. What is the value of f of x they have given? Ax plus b divided by x plus 1. If limit extends to 0, f of x is equal to 2. Okay, one first what they have given? Limit extends to 0, f of x equal to 2. And limit extends to infinity, f of x is equal to 1. Then show that f of minus 2 equal to 0. We have to prove f of minus 2 value is 0. We have to prove at the last step. Clear? First, what they have given? They have given f of x value. So, write that f of x value. F of x equal to ax plus b divided by x plus 1. Then also what they have given? Limit extends to 0. F of x is equal to 2 they have given. First, we'll take that alone. See, limit extends to 0, f of x is equal to 2, this they have given in the question. So, limit extends to 0, f of x value is what we are having? This is our f of x, isn't it? So, in the f of x place, we are substituting ax plus b divided by x plus 1 is equal to 2. Clear? Next step, if you see, we are applying the limit to inside. X tends to 0. X tends to 0 means wherever you are having x, you are going to substitute 0. Clear? A, x you are having. So, A into 0 is what? 0 plus B. We have no x, so no need to substitute A. Plus B divided by. Instead of x, what we have to put now? 0. X tends to 0. So, 0 plus 1. Clear? 0 plus B is what? B. 0 plus 1 is 1 equal to 2. Next, if you cross multiply this 1 means we will get b equal to 2. Clear? Now, we have got one value. What value is that? B value we have got. What is that? B equal to 2. Using the first given, we have found the b value. Next, we are going to take this concept. Limit extends to infinity, f of x equal to 1. This also they have given in the question itself. So again, next step, limit extends to infinity, f of x value is what? Ax plus b divided by x plus 1 is equal to 1. Clear? I have told you from the part 3 video itself, wherever you are getting limit extends to infinity, what I have told, wherever you are getting limit extends to infinity means you have to write 1 by x tends to 0. You have to write, I have told you in part 3 video itself. Isn't it? See here, x tends to infinity we are having. So in the next step, if you see, limit 1 by x tends to 0, I have written. isn't it? Now, after writing the limit, after changing the limit, what the next step we have to do? We have to take the x commonly out in the numerator and as well as in the denominator. Clear? See, if I take x commonly out here, here x went outside, remaining only what? A. So right here A. In the part 3 itself I have told you, see here no x is there. So for any term, if you are not having x, means what I have told, you have to write the x in the denominator part. Clear? Yes, since we are taking x commonly out, here we are having x, so x went outside, remaining is only a, here no x term, but where we have to write the x? We have to write the x in the denominator part. Why we are writing like that? So if you multiply this x inside, x into a is ax, x into b is bx divided by x, xx will get cancelled, no, we will get this correct only. The next step, we are taking x commonly out. This x went outside, so 1, we have no x, so what you have to write? 1 divided by x you have to write. Clear? X, x will get cancelled. Remaining inside, what we are having? What we are having? A plus b by x we are having. Okay? Now b by x we are having, isn't it? See, b by x. B by x means what? B into 1 by x, isn't it? B by x means what? B into 1 by x. Now we are applying the limit. B, 1 by x, what is the answer? 1 by x tends to 0. So, B by x, now value is what? Equal to B into 1 by x tends to 0. So, B into 0 is 0. Clear? So, I have written here, A plus B by x value is now got what? B into 0 is what? 0. Which is equal to 0. So a plus 0 we have got. Clear? Similarly, in the denominator part also, we are substituting the limit inside. Whenever you are substituting the limit inside, next step you should not write that limit. L-I-M, we should not write. Clear? Now 1 by x tends to 0 we are having. So here we are having 1 by x. So this now it will become 0. So 1 plus 0 is equal to 1 we are having equal to 1. Clear? Now a plus 0 is a, 1 plus 0 is 1, equal to this side 1. Clear all of you now? Now if you see, if you take this cross multiply, a is equal to 1. Clear? Now with this given, we have found the b value. With this given, we have got the a value. But what we have to show? F of minus 2 is equal to 0 we have to prove. Isn't it? First, for that we have to, now we have got a value and b value. Isn't it? First, we substitute a value and b value in f of x. Here, we are going to substitute a value and b value in f of x. So, what is our f of x is equal to ax plus b divided by x plus 1. Clear? Is equal to a value, what we have got? 1. So 1 into x plus b value is what we are having? 2. So plus 2 divided by x plus 1. X into 1 is next step, x plus 2 divided by x plus 1. Now this is our f of x. But what we have to prove? F of minus 2 is equal to 0 we have to prove. So in the place of x you write minus 2. F of minus 2. So in the place of x we are writing here minus 2. So wherever you are having x you write now minus 2. Clear? Here x means here also x we are having. So in the place of x we are having minus 2. So wherever you are having x, there also you have to substitute minus 2. Clear? So x we are having, so minus 2 plus 2 divided by, here x we are having minus 2 plus 1. Minus 2 plus 2 is what? 0 divided by minus 2 plus 1 is what? Minus 1 is equal to 0 divided by any number is what? Answer 0 only. So which is equal to 0. Therefore f of minus 2 is equal to 0. Clear? Ends proved. That's all. That only they are asking to prove, no? F of minus 2 equal to 0 we have to prove. We have proved. So write the last step. Ends proved. Clear students, 5th question. Next you are going to see your assignment problem. Part 4 assignment, 5 questions you are going to do. See the first question. limit extends to infinity, 6 minus 5x square divided by 4x plus 15x square. See, see students, for each question I am giving the int. Based on the int, if you are trying, then surely you will get the answer. Don't copy the answer from anywhere. You itself try. Okay, if you are copying from anywhere, means there only direct answer will be there. In between some step, they will be skipped. So you should not supposed to skip any steps. You have to follow all the steps. See, first in this problem, what we are going to do is, see, x tends to infinity they are given. So I have told you many times, whenever you are having x tends to infinity, immediately you change that into 1 by x tends to 0 you are going to change. That only I have written in that int. And after writing that, you have to see the x value, which is the highest value, highest power in the numerator, x square. So take that x square commonly out. So if you know x square means 6 divided by x square, you have to write. Similarly, in denominator also you are going to take x square commonly out. Then remaining you know the final step, according to that you solve and find the answer. Clear? Second question. Limit n tends to infinity, summation n square divided by n cube. Can you able to recall where we have seen the summation n square? Yes, we have seen in 10th standard in some of the series, isn't it? So what formula is this? Summation n square means n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. See, here also you are having n tends to infinity. Here no need to change it in the starting itself. You just substitute the formula and you take this n cube for each n. N divided by n cube, n plus 1 divided by n cube, 2n plus 1 divided by n cube. For each term you write, and then at last you can take 1 divided by n tends to 0. You can change it. Clear? Little bit you have to use your knowledge. Only then you can find the answer. Clear? Third question. Limit n x tends to 0. Third question is what? Limit x tends to 0, log 1 plus x cube divided by sine cube x. Students, see this question. Based on the log, some formulas I have written in the part 3 video, which is what the heading of that is, some standard limits I have gave you. In that fourth formula is what means. See, this is the fourth formula. Limit x tends to 0, log 1 plus x divided by x is equal to 1. See here, log 1 plus x. X means same x is, it is in the denominator. Isn't it? So, log 1 plus x, instead of x, we are having x cube. So, same x cube should be have to have in the denominator part also. But we are not having. So what we are going to do, we are going to multiply and divide by x cube. Okay, so when we are dividing by x cube, we will get in denominator 1 x cube. Isn't it? So log 1 plus x cube divided by x cube, that full value I have to take it as 1. Clear? Then you will multiply, you know, x cube divided by sine cube, yes. Sine cube x. For that only you are going to substitute limit x tends to 0 and you are going to find the answer. Clear? Fourth question is, if x power n minus 2 power n divided by x minus 2 is equal to 448. Students, fourth question is exercise 5.2, third question this is. Clear? So in exercise 5.2, we have left the third problem. That time I have told you that's your homework, isn't it? So that is that problem this is. So this is exercise problem, fourth question. If x power n minus 2 power n divided by x minus 2 is equal to 448, then find the least positive integer n. So, see, I have told you in many times, wherever you are having the power, immediately what formula your mind has to strike? See, there I have written limit x tends to a, x power n minus a power n divided by x minus a equal to n into a power n minus 1. Okay, after applying that formula, you have to substitute the value for n. Okay, you can take the n value, you can substitute the n value, put n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, till you put, when you are getting the same 448, suppose when you are substituting n is equal to 6, by that time you are getting the answer as 448 means, then n equal to 6 is your answer. Suppose when you are substituting n equal to 4, by that time if you are getting equal to 448 means, then n equal to 7 is your answer. According to that you have to find. Clear? The last fifth question is, limit z tends to 4, square root of z minus 2 divided by z minus 4. Students, I am not going to give any in for this. You cannot directly apply z tends to 4, they have given. No, you should not directly apply wherever you are having z, you should not put 4 in the first step itself. Okay, little bit you have to think the same model we have done in the exercise problem also. Okay, first go through the video one or two times, get clear the concept very well, then you can start doing your assignment. Clear? In part 3, I gave you one creative problem, isn't it? That problem answer now we are going to see. With that answer, we will wind up this session part 4. Clear? Thank you students. Next, we are going to see what? Part 3, assignment problem, creative problem. Next, now we are going to see. This is the part 3 creative assignment problem. See what I have given, the limit h tends to 0, 6 plus h the whole square minus 36 divided by h we are having. See, 6 plus h the whole square means what? This is in what formula we are having? A plus b the whole square formula, isn't it? So a plus b the whole square formula is what? A square 2ab plus b square. According to that I have expanded, instead of a we are adding 6, so I have written 6 the whole square plus 2 into a into b, so 2 into a is 6, b is h, so 2 into 6 into h plus b is what? h the whole square minus 36 divided by h. Clear? Limit h tends to 0, 6 square is what? 36. 6 2's are what? 12h plus h square minus 36 divided by h. Next, in this step, plus 36 and minus 36 are getting cancelled. So, remaining will be what? H square plus 12h is the remaining, isn't it? Now, if you see h square plus 12h divided by h we are having. So, from the numerator h square we are having, we can take 1h commonly out. If we take 1h commonly out, we are getting h plus 12, isn't it? So from h square 1h is outside, so remaining 1h, 12h already 1h is outside, so only 12 we are going to write. In denominator we are having h, no, so this h and this h are getting cancelled. So remaining is what? Limit h tends to 0, h plus 12. Now we can easily substitute the limit inside. So h tends to 0 means where you are having h you have to put 0. Clear? So 0 plus 12 equal to 12. So now the answer is what? 12 is our answer. Clear? How many of you have got the same answer? Check by yourself. Okay? If you have got wrong answer means see where you have done wrong and correct it. Okay, students, but everybody has to try the creative problem. Clear? So that only you can deeply understand the concept. So if I go for the higher concept, you can able to understand also. If you are not just trying, nothing you cannot able to understand. Clear? So this week assignment problem and creative problem, everything solved by yourself by the day itself. Maintain the classwork and assignment notebook with neat and good presentation. That is very, very important. Okay. You have to write neatly. See, if I am not having space, I am writing the remaining part this side means, but you should not do like that. You have to continue below. Here, how we have written the 10th standard, the same like you are going to write the 11th standard classwork also. But with good presentation and handwriting. Clear, students? Next, we'll meet you in the part 5 session. Thank you, students.